gonna be a total mess.
On your right. Hold your line. Clear right. Car right. Still there. Still there. Clear right.
Come on, dude, are you serious?
Come on, Andy, forget the start, just get stuck in, mate. Straw is now leading.
So we don't have any damage.
Behind us now, 0.5. Clear right.
That guy nearly took us out then.
Sorry.
Thanks, Jim. Appreciate that, eh?
Yellow flag, watch out. Car left, left side. Clear left, car left. Still there. Still there. Still there. Hold your line.
It's going to end well.
Hold your line. B11. Sector 3 is 3.1 seconds. Clear left.
Should have tried to follow that guy through then, but...
Okay, Andy. The next car is Miller. Position, don't let him through. lap 2. Miller ahead is now 0.5. Lap time was at 149.76. Sector 3 is 2.8. Off the pace. There's an incident in Cova Grande.
Nice work.
I'm gonna let this guy go. It's a big risk to take him out under the brakes, I think. Rather than take somebody else out. Unless we can pull away from him.
Is now 0.47. Nice one, Andy. This is great. Come on, keep nailing those exits. P9, that's the fastest lap.
So if I get down the inside of this guy coming down there, I can definitely get him on the brakes. He's braking about 20-30 metres earlier than we would.
After 29 minutes.
It's one of my weak points on the track, is getting a decent exit out of this sector, and it's going to take a good exit to get past this guy.
Okay, Andy, stay close, wait for him to make a mistake.
It just seems it's that first part of the sector there that I don't seem to be carrying enough speed.
Stay on it. That's the fastest lap of the race. That was 148.122. Front is now 0.7.
mistake at the same time. The tyres are starting to feel it though. Shift down, please. Jesus.
Has now decreased to 1.1 seconds. The gap to Villa ahead is now 1.1.
This downshifting issue is really affecting me. It's putting me off.
Place. 62 is 0.9 off the pace.
Whether it's my shifter or whether it's some sort of lag. Definitely not having any issues going up the box.
Seconds. Okay, Andy, you've used half your fuel.
Don't seem to be taking any time out of him now under the race. Thank you. 3 driver. So. Can't feel too bad. Chief, what's my tyre wear?
We haven't got that data.
Awesome. Chief.
Miller, ahead is pitting.
What's my bodywork damage?
Can't aim out. 7th position. Sector 1 is 0.28 off the pace. Sector 2 is 0.6 off the pace. Sector 3 is 0.46 off the pace.
Chief. What's my bodywork damage? Seriously?
It's now about 6.9 seconds.
Feel windows open. Pit stop, windows open. I'm in. Potentially lose 3 places here for screws pit stop, but these guys are quite close. Chief, calculate fuel to the end.
4 minutes. We should need 5 litres.
That's great.
The gap behind is now 1.9 seconds. You've just done a 48.41. Sector 3 is 0.6 off the pace. Good consistency. Keep it coming.
Lose one to the pits. Do another couple of laps, yeah, at least.
Thank you.
Morning, John. The car feels awesome, dude. It's just the driver. It's the problem, as always.
Okay, Andy, we're halfway through. Should be about 9 minutes of fuel remaining.
How many kilometers have you worked on this
time? Was at 48.10. Sector 2 is 0.7 off the pace. 6.
It does seem to be the quickest through there. Definitely having to lift up a lot more through that sector now. I'm not getting a bite out of the front tyres like I was.
Sectors 1 and 3 are 0.41 off the face. Sector 2 is 0.7 off the face.
Slow down.
The gap in front is now 8.4 seconds.
Must have taken too much of that first turn. Brought a few drivers into play now for our position.
Okay Andy, relax, focus, keep it smooth. B7, sector 2 is 0.7 off the pace. The gap behind is now 3.3 seconds.
There's a car exiting the pits, heads up. Watch your speed.
Wasn't a great entry. See where that brings us out.
Looks like you're clear on the pit exit.
P12, P13. We'll still behind Miller, so Daniel, I'm pretty sure Daniel was behind us before. This guy is really reeling us in. Downshifting issues come back.
Front is Miller. Meredith is now in the lead.
Find out whether we took damage in that first turn at the start of the race.
The car in front is pitting.
We were running in the 47s in practice, the same track temperature, so.
The gap behind is now 1.2 seconds. P8. That's good consistency, keep it up.
Were made.
The gap to Miller ahead is increasing. It's now 7.9.
I make a mistake? Looks like it. Whip out the WD-40 on this shifter.
That lap was a 149.05. Sector 1 is 0.7 off the pace.
Shift, come on, Jesus Christ.
Andy. Don't let this guy distract you.
It's not him that's distracting me. It's this goddamn shifter. Chief, be quiet.
P8.
P8. Okay. You're not gonna dummy me, mate. Not today. We've got 3 laps left. This one, maybe 2 more.
Left, clear left.
Awesome. Pretty sure I left him room on the outside there.
Side. He's still there. Still there. Still there. He's still there. Clear left. Left side. Clear left.
Should get the white flag on this lap.
We estimate you've got 5 minutes of fuel remaining.
I think he's got issues behind him. I think that's going to be our saving grace. Not sure I could have done another lap with that kind of defending. Give him his dues though, he gave it a good go.
Sector 2 is a second off the pace. Clear left.
Awesome. That is fucking ridiculous.
Sorry, man. It wasn't intentional.
Right side's clear. Oh, Andy. Car right. Right side's clear. There's an incident in Cobra Grande. You think it might be Baptiste?
At least the car's pointing the right way. Thank you. Is he sorry enough to give the position back, though? That's the question. He came from a long way back. I don't think we broke too early.
We address it before the lightning. Go in the inside.
You're a good man, Daniel.
Clear left.
Appreciate that,
that's the end of the race.
Bad luck,
mate.
Wow.
No worry, mate. It was, like I said, wasn't intentional. Just caught me out a little bit.
That was a good battle anyway, Daniel.
Yeah, it was, mate. Really enjoyed it. Thank you.
You'll see that every day on iRacing. That was insane.